Hello everyone, how are you? I hope you are not just doing fine but doing awesome at your home. Today's video is focused on how to maintain your nano reef tank. I have been maintaining my 10 gallon nano reef tank for about an year now. I have two clownfish and few corals inside. In this video, you get a chance to win a $30 mystery reef tank box free. There is no catch. You not even have to shell out a single buck out of your pocket and you get your mystery box delivered at your doorsteps. Mystery box contains some supplies that could be useful in maintaining your tank. All you need is to watch this video till the end. I'll explain you all the process how you can enroll yourself and win a $30 mystery box. This is the fish tank that we will be cleaning today. I tend to clean my fish tank every other weekend, but this time it got delayed. I'll also be moving my tank to the living room because I need a little more space to work on my working desk. I try to use RODA water for my fish tank. You can buy RODA water either from your local fish store, which they sell it around 50 cents per gallon. The price may vary depending upon the place where you live. Or you can buy a machine and create your RODA water by yourself. So I bought this machine from Amazon. I'll place the link in the description in case you want to buy it. Before we start cleaning our process, there are few accessories that we would require.
We need couple of buckets to remove and fill water into the aquarium, some towels to clean the spills, a hose to clean the gravel, a scrubber to clean the aquarium glass, filter media, a pump, a thermometer and refractometer to tell us the salinity. Try to maintain salinity between 32 to 33 points.
First step in our cleaning process is to get the water ready. We have to maintain the water temperature same as our aquarium's current water temperature. I have water in my bucket, salinity match with the current aquarium water. Bringing the water to the same temperature, it might take some time. While we are getting our water ready, I would like to thank all of you for showing your love in my previous video. And I would like to expect the same from you this time and even better. When you hit that subscribe button, it makes me motivated. When you hit that like button, it makes me happy. And when you share this video with other friends, it makes me overwhelmed. Keep me motivated and happily overwhelmed by subscribing, liking and sharing this video with your friends. You can also get your reef mystery box delivered at your doorstep. Only things that you need to do is hit the subscribe button. In comments below, type in your email ID and answer a simple question. The question is, what should be the acceptable salinity and phosphate level for your reef tank? The answer resides in this video itself. When you get this mystery box, it could have any item that could help to maintain your reef tank.
You need to cut the electricity from your aquarium. The phosphate level for the aquarium should be between 0 to 0.5. Now, take all the appliances and keep it safe in a bucket.
All you need to do is grab your scrubber and start scrubbing your glass.
This step has to be performed before taking any water out from the aquarium.
Now you need to grab your hose and start sucking the water out.
If you're using new filter media, wash your media under running water until the black color stops coming out. You see the clear water coming out from your media. I have shifted the aquarium to my living room and placed the filter media inside the filter. Now it's time to fill the water inside the aquarium. This is how our clean running system looks at the end.
So we are done with our aquarium cleaning. There are a few tips for you guys. Tip number one, keep the lights off for the day. Today, you have done your aquarium cleaning. Keep the lights off. It will help fish to relax and recover them for water change shock. Tip number 2. Don't feed your fish same day you did the water change. Rather, feed your fish a day prior and day after the water change. Don't worry, it won't harm your fish. Tip number 3. Feed less. I know everyone likes to feed their fishes very often, but it's a mistake. To maintain a good water parameters, you need to feed less to your fishes. I feed my fishes every third day and it helps me maintain excellent water levels. Tip number 4. You need to check your water level daily. Evaporation will bring your water levels down. To maintain those water levels, you need to use the fresh water. Don't use salt water. It will increase the salinity and your fishes and corals will die. At last, I would like to thank you all for giving me your precious time and watching this video. See you again in my next video. Till then, stay safe and enjoy rest of your day.